a major anchor in economic development, not just for Worcester, but for the region, is St. Vincent Hospital. And I'm thrilled to have with us the interim CEO and COO, a couple mm-hmm. different hats, Ava right. Collins. Welcome.
Right. Well, Tim, thanks for having me on the show. I've been at St. Vincent Hospital for 3 years right. now. Celebrating this month is my third year anniversary.
Congratulations.
And well, thank you. It's just been an honor, and I've been humbled to be able to serve and lead an organization like St. Vincent. I think right. providing great health care to the community. And in fact, we've been providing that care for 125 years. We celebrated just last year our anniversary as right. an institution. And my 3 years have just been exceptional here. And we continue to do great things. I've been in healthcare for 30 years. And I had a great opportunity to come and be a part of the great things that are going on
yes.
in Central yeah. Massachusetts, and St. Vincent certainly wants to be a part of that.
Yeah, well, you mentioned 125 years. I know that I've been a part of it for 50, having been born up on the campus on Vernon Hill, but and a few visits in between. But it's a phenomenal, and I don't think there's a family in Central Massachusetts that doesn't have a connection in some shape, manner, or form with St. Vincent's. And that continues, and it evolves. Clearly, as we talk about the renaissance that's taking place in Worcester, those things don't happen overnight. They happen over time, and organizations and institutions and businesses having the courage to make strategic decisions. St. Vincent did that with the then Medical City being a major anchor in the downtown and a major employer.
Right. I think we moved to downtown in 2000, so just a great opportunity for us to be a part of the heart of the city,
right.
and we're proud of that. That's a perfect location for us, right in the middle of the city, and with the Renaissance, exciting for us to be a part of that. I think we're aligned with you and with the city when, we think about drawing on our rich history with a mindset of growth.
Right.
And as the city grows, we as an institution have an opportunity and an obligation to look at what the community needs from a healthcare perspective. And our great team of physicians and right. nurses and leaders, we're on the ready
right.
as we continue to grow in Worcester.
And that growth is important. Healthcare, everybody needs it. But
right.
then as you think of how the Central Mass economy has evolved over those 125 years of which St. Vincent has been such a critical part, healthcare is now the biggest employer in the region, and you employ a lot of people.
We do. We employ 2,500 people, and then we have another 700 physicians that choose to take care of their patients at our facility. So, exciting to us as we see industry, communities, and even our baseball team coming.
Right.
We're excited about that. And we partner closely with schools and universities to be clinical training site
right.
For future leaders in healthcare. And we have 120 residents right at St. Vincent Hospital. We think that's important for us
right.
to play an educational and
right.
academic role and continue to give back to the economy and to make sure that we have caregivers in the future.
And those residents come from across the country, across the globe, come to Worcester, have a great chance to work in a first-class facility and a culture, and then hopefully stay in the city and the region afterwards.
Absolutely, and many of them do. We just had match day, and so we're excited to bring students in. They get a great experience, both in the city, but certainly their clinical training at St. Vincent, and they do want to stay. And that works for all of us.
Right. 2000, as you mentioned, the downtown state-of-the-art hospital opened. But, while that seems relatively new, even during the course of that time up until recently, you continue to make investments into the hospital, into the facility.
Yeah, absolutely. That's important to us. We're invested in this community. We are committed to providing the top quality health care that this city deserves and that all of our patients deserve. And we look at all times to be offering the best programs, the best technology, making sure we have the best doctors,
right.
and we'll continue to do that.
One of the things that St. Vincent, certainly during your tenure, and the role that you initially came here for, and then now as the interim CEO and COO. You know, St. Vincent is not confined to the facility in the downtown. You're also a very engaged partner with organizations and groups. Recently, you were one of the lead sponsors of the American Heart Association Heart and Stroke Ball.
Yeah. You know, we do great work inside the hospital walls. And, you know, we also think that it's a responsibility for our teams and talent to get outside of the walls. And we do partner with a lot of community organizations. Big part of what we do. It's a big part of our commitment. You mentioned the American Heart. You know, it's easy for us to partner with like cause organizations. Right. So when you think about heart disease being the number one killer, and our attention and focus on heart disease and heart health, a perfect partnership. American Heart does great work, and we were proud to sponsor and proud to be a part of that. And there are a lot of others,
too. Yeah, no, I just, in the notes in preparing for the American Heart Association, but organ donation, you know, the YMCA's Live Strong program, we've seen the opioid crisis impact everyone, and you've been involved in that symposium as well, and hosting some of our chamber events relating to the healthcare roundtable over the years, too.
Absolutely. We're pleased to do that. You mentioned the opioid crisis, certainly devastating to all of us, devastating to Worcester. We are committed to doing our part, obviously. We are having a symposium at the DCU Center May 21st, and that's sponsored by St. Vincent and our actual St. Vincent Opioid Task Force and our Nursing Education Council. So we would invite everyone to come out and learn more about what you can do to help fight the crisis.
Right. And assisting us, I want to say thank you for that, too, the Worcester Women's Leadership Conference coming up. You know, we've got about a minute and a half left. You know, I mentioned a major employer, and you talk about the match day with the resident, you know, future docs coming in. But lots of career paths and opportunities in the healthcare industry at an organization like St. Vincent's.
Absolutely. Some people think, you know, doctors and nurses, it's much more than that. I mean, we partner, I was just meeting with our friends at Quinn Sigman and talking about the different tracks that they provide. And so there's techs and pharmacists and business leaders and just a lot of different opportunity in healthcare itself beyond the clinical piece. Right. Clinical, certainly the focus, but the supportive and ancillary services, you know, allow the clinical team to do what they need to do as far as taking care of our patients.
Right, the whole back end of the operation, the administrative piece, you know, restaurants, food, everything.
Sure.
It's a city in and of itself.
It really is.
Where it is. Well, Ava, we want to thank you for being here with us. Thank you for being such an engaged partner and leader in our community and leading such a great organization. We look forward to having you and members of your team back soon.
Thank you so much, Tim. St. Vincent's proud to be a part of this exciting time in Worcester.
That's